absolutely shot under that. On its day, with the right conditions, it's such a sort of underestimated way of fishing. There's no better way. Like, we're into spring now, and obviously it's been quite a cold spring this year. And I know from past experience going to commercials like I am today at Willowmarsh Fishery near Kidderminster. It's an absolutely stunning fishery, as you can see. It's one I've fished a few times. But there's one way of fishing I think is very underestimated, and that's fishing a waggler. Now, especially when you're fishing on the bottom with waggler for carp with pellets. And that's what this film's gonna be about today. Now, the actual components are very, very important, but very, very simple. Now, I've set up two rods for today, one for fishing on the bottom and one for fishing shallow. Now, my bottom setup is a 13-foot Sapira X. These are brand new this year. They're due to come out very shortly. There's an 11-foot pellet waggler, there's a 12-foot carp, and I'm fishing with the 13-foot sort of all-rounder, if you like. So whether you're river fishing, you know, natural lake fishing, or doing what I'm doing on the bottom today, this rod does it all. So that's the rod. It's an absolutely stunning bit of kit. Real choice, really important again. You know, whether you're fishing pellet waggler or like I am on the bottom as well today, fishing on with a normal sort of traditional waggler, if you like, a small reel, that's a 320. Really, really important. Keep everything nice and light and nice and small. And I've got on there 5-pound float max, so it's gonna be good for casting and obviously strong enough to get the carp out, because there are some actually real big carp in this lake. So that's the rod, that's the reel, that's the main line. One just important thing for me, I'm fishing with a Centris 320 reel, but that reel comes with a double handle. Now, if you can, when you're doing a lot of waggler fishing, whatever sort of waggler fish you're doing, rivers, you know, still waters, try and get the option of a double handle reel. That's why I go for the Centris, because it's well balanced, and that's really important when you're waggler fishing. Now, float choice, and the whole setup is simple. I've got a Jura plastic waggler on there, nice and thick top, yellow is showing out there, absolutely brilliant. And we all know sometimes yellow is the perfect color for when you're fishing. So I've got a 4-gram waggler on there, and you can see from there I've got some stops and I've got a swivel. Now that is a waggler kit, it don't get easier. So it's called the stops waggler kit, like that. And all you do, we all know by now, you just put your main line through before you set up, and that whole system just goes on your main line. So you end up with one stop above your float and two above, because it's always the, sorry, one above and two below. Now the two below basically take all the pressure of you casting and striking. That's why we give you two below. So that's a setup. With float wise, just go down the main line a little bit. Now I've got two number 8 stots. One is above the foot hook length of 015 and a 14 KKM hook with a simple band on, and the other stot is about a foot above. I just wanted to put, when I'm fishing on the bottom in like 6 foot of water like I am, I think just having those two number 8s like down the line keeps everything a little bit tighter, and to me it just makes complete sense. And I've plumbed up using a big triple SSG non-toxic shot. I've clipped that on the hook, I've plumbed up, and I'm fishing roughly about 3 inches over depth. So I've plumbed up, nice and simple. It's really important that you get that right. So I just clipped that on, cast out. I've actually got a float that doesn't take as much shot. So when it's actually, obviously that shot sinks that float, and I can get it and get it and get it. So I'm fishing dead right, and with the wind like it is today, it's really, really easy to do. So that's my setup for fishing on the bottom. For fishing for the pellet waggler, now with the conditions today, it's quite cold this morning. Hopefully the sun will come out. As I keep feeding, I'll get some indications on me float that I'm fishing on the bottom, and I might catch on a pellet waggler, or I might even have to fish that float, what I just showed you, like sort of 3 foot deep, I don't know. But anyway, I've set a pellet waggler up. Fingers crossed we catch on it later in the session. Now I've got the Sapira X 12-foot carp. It's an absolute, again, it's an all-rounder. Whether you're fishing pellet waggler, whether you're fishing on the bottom, you don't want to fish a 13-foot rod, and also some of your river fishing it's going to cover. Same reel, 320 Centris, double handle, 5-pound float max main line, and a simple Jura pellet waggler on there, 6-gram, and exactly the same. Leave that little gap. On both setups, I've got about an inch. And that's really important. It helps you keep everything nice and straight when you're casting. Don't have them like really tight like that. Always have that little 1 inch gap. So that's a nice little tip there. Again, 12 inch hook length of 0.15. I've opted for 0.15 because I know these fish at the moment, it's still a bit nippy. They might be a little bit wary. And we'll see how I can always change. I can always go up to 0.17. I've got some hook lengths done. Like I said, 12 inches, 14 kkm, bit lighter hook. If it was full on summer fishing, I'd probably be fishing with 6 pound mainline, 0.17 hook length and a kkh hook. But today, every fish is going to be important. It's not going to be that easy, I don't think. So there you go. That's the two setups. Really, really simple. I'm absolutely itching to get going. And obviously I'll talk you through everything that I'm doing whilst we're fishing. Just started the session now. Now I'm fishing a nice little area. I've got a lovely little bit of a willow. Obviously I'm just coming, it's miles away from the island. And I've just started, you can probably see from the camera, that float, because it's a thick top float. Really important when you're fishing, I've only just got, all on my bait tray, it is so simple. I've got some 8mm and 6mm pellets. And to be honest, I can't really see the 6mm come into play unless I'm really struggling. And having a thick top float. When I used to do a lot of chub fishing years ago on the River Avon, fishing for chub shallow, having a thick top float was the best way for fishing for big fish sometimes, because you can have it dotted down, it shows up really well, and any sort of skim and little waves, it actually sort of takes it better than what an inserted float would be. So just bear that in mind when you're doing this sort of fish. It's not all about fishing with inserted floats. I do a lot of like Waggler fishing, like for roach and skimmers, and obviously inserted floats can be absolutely deadly, a bit more sensitive. But when you're fishing for carp on the bottom, like I'm doing at the moment, it is nice to have a, like a thick top float. You can see it. Just give that a little flick. So I've cast out, I've fed. I'm not overdoing it at the moment. I'm just taking it nice and easy. Just feeding like 6 to 10 pellets, 8mm. Trying to get it in a nice little area, size of a car. You know, if you think like the size of a car, you're not going to get them. You don't want it too tight when you're fishing a wagon, because it is about sort of going around your peg a little bit. I've got, you'll probably notice from my setup, I've got a nice big rod rest on the front. Oh, that absolutely shot under that. So that's a good start. So just check that hook length, make sure your hair rig is not tangled or anything like that. And then casting out, just get everything smooth. Like that. And then just stop it. Little flick of the rod. Like that. Just watch it now. I mean, I know we've only just started, but sometimes you'll get them on the drop. And believe you me, if you can fish a waggler, the difference in your catch rate, you know, you can chuck a little bomb out over there if the conditions were right. There was a little tiny indication. That was a bow wave off the top then. So there's a few fish moving about. We've only just started. Let's get him back out. That's better. Little flick of the rod. That's a nice, having like a nice tippy rod, because it helps you get your line down. So get on your catapult, like 5 or 6 pellets. And I'm gonna feed twice. One, it makes a bit of noise. Spread them out a little bit, not too much. And like I said, going back to the rod rest, I've got a big rod rest, which is really nice when you're fishing a waggler. You don't want nothing too small. Like when you're feeder fishing, you normally got a... Oh, hello. So what I do now, I've got my clutch set. Back wind off. I've hooked a nice carp. I love Willowmarsh. Honestly, it's an absolutely stunning fishery. You can see it. I've always called it like Jurassic Park when you look round. It's so green and lush. And I would say at the moment that water temperature is like 10, 12 degrees, still quite cold. But any sun now, they will be straight up off the bottom. But going back to what I was saying, like if you had a straight lead out there, honestly, I mean, we watch all the underwater footage and stuff, and they suck your bait in these carp, spit it out, and that's where this waggler, on its day with the right conditions, is such a sort of underestimated way of fishing. And that's why we do these little films. So I've got my back wind off. You can just hear the clutch. Or that then when that carp was like just nodding. Just gives you that little bit of confidence. If it does shoot off, even though I've got the back wind off, it's not going to snap your hook length. There's all sorts of size fish in this lake. They go from sort of mid doubles to sort of 2 or 3 pound. So I'm not sure how big this one is. Probably 4 or 5 pound by the feel of that. And, you know, just take your time. Don't lose the plot. See, a lot of people waggler fishing, they're like pulling so hard, there's just no need of it. Just control pressure. Really important about the waggler, having that like dumpy waggler. Sort of thick top. See, proper scrapping fish they are. So I've just got my finger around my reel to stop it moving. And he's trying to get down the inside. And I've been to venues where I fished a bomb and you get an odd one, and then when them conditions change and you can fish a waggler, the difference in catch rate is incredible. It's like they're just sucking your bait in on a bomb, spitting it out. I know sometimes you can't do it because of the conditions and that, but if you can, honestly, having a waggler on the deck, it's massive. You need the right venue, obviously. Open water venues, obviously, a bit like this today, ideal. Whether you're pleasure fishing or match fishing, it's a great way of catching carp. And look at the bait tray, it's so simple. A couple of tubs of pellets. So I get the carp in my net like that. I've put the back wind back on. I can put that under my bum cheek. Get the hook out of the fish. Straight in the net like that. Pellet's still on the hook, but I'm gonna change that. Make sure your hair rig is, the line's coming off the back of the hook. 8mm pellet. Always try and go for the 8mm pellet, which ain't quite too elongated. Some of the pellets are a little bit longer. I try and get a nice shaped pellet because it flies through the air a lot better. Feed a few pellets. Not, as I said, don't overcook it at the moment, even though we just caught one. Bang on that. Cast that a little bit out of to the left, that one, and get back into the rhythm. That's the one. Get that line down, flick a couple of flicks. Obviously, feeding, just take it easy at the start. Just feel your way into it. I'm not going to overcook it, as it might be one of them days, but I also want to make sure I feed quite regularly, because hopefully we will catch on that pellet waggler later on. You never know. I'm sitting there absolutely lovely. The wind's just off my left shoulder, which is nice. Obviously, if I was on that other bank today, you'd struggle to fish a waggler. You could fish it, but it wouldn't be so easy to feed. And obviously you'll have a lot of bow. That's where you'd have to probably put a little bit of water down ferry liquid on your line to get the line down, where this side, it's a lot easier. Just another little flick. I'm just gonna pick my catapult up again. Just fire a few pellets around my float. A couple more, just to make a little bit of noise. Obviously want to try and get a bit of bait in the peg as well. And obviously we are maybe... And sometimes it's like fishing the pole, you sit there, you don't get a bite, you make that little bit of noise, even though you're fishing on the bottom, it makes an indication. Oh, a little bit too over to the right, that one. Need to calm myself down a bit. That's perfect, that. So try and hit the, when you cast, you see the float go through the air, and just before it sort of hits the water, you want to stop it with your finger on the spool so your hook bait goes past your float. That's absolutely bang on. That's where I need to be fishing. There's two platforms opposite. I'm trying to fish, when I plumbed up, I'm trying to fish bang in the middle of those two platforms. Don't want to get too near the cover because you're going to get yourself in a bit of a mess. Make sure that line's down. Nice to get a couple of bites straight away, which is important. And it's the sort of thing in match fishing sometimes, you can sort of prime this line up. You might not catch on it for like maybe a few hours, and then all of a sudden they rock up and you can absolutely empty the joint. That had to be on that. Absolutely flew under. Might, there is some F1s in this lake as well, so this might be an F1. You do miss, Waggler fishing's not always the best for F1s. You do miss a lot of, but oh no, perhaps not. That is not an F1. It's just swam towards me, that. That feels, ooh. The line's just gone over his back then. Yes, that's what we want. So just let the rod do the work. I could probably just about get away with that 12 footer if I wanted to fish on the bottom, but that 13 foot, for the distance I'm fishing and the depth I'm fishing, I think the 12 foot would just be right on its maximum, where the 13 just gives you that. Obviously it's a lot easier to fish with in depth. And it also gives you the casting ability to get that little float. It's only a little float, 4 grams. It's not a massive float. Especially when you're using like 5 or 6 pound main line. If you use 3 pound main line, it'd be a lot easier, but obviously we're catching big carps, so you're gonna be a bit risky. Especially with fishing like 5 pound, sort of neuron the same lengths as well. If you had 8 pound main line, you'd have to fish a bigger float. So it's always a compromise with Waggler fishing. But consider we've got nothing to damage the line nowadays because of them stops on the line. I mean, years ago, you'd be putting like big SSG shot and AAs on there. Them days are sort of numbered, really. But what a way of catching carp. I know one thing, my right arm's going to be hurting if this carries on. Lovely. Maybe 6-7 pound, I would have thought, that one. Keep everything nice and smooth. Let's get him up, have a look at him. Typical Willowmarsh farm, absolutely perfect condition. and also the right, you know, the perfect size for doing what we're doing today, catching that. And then fish are surprisingly cold. Probably, like I said, 6-7 pound of Willowmarsh carp. Whoa, let's get him back. Proper fired up, these are. I'll take that pellet off again. And I'm just going to keep going now, like firing those pellets in. And honestly, I'm not sure what's going to happen yet, but it might just be the day where we can just do what we're doing. But I have had it before where you can have a run like that, and also you start getting liners, and that's the time to either put this, you can either bring this float that we're using off the bottom, or get the pellet wag out. Just don't overcook it at the moment. Nice little flick of the rod to get that line down. It might just be the case I can use this float for fishing like three and a half foot deep if they don't want to come right up for the pellet wag. But that's something we got to like see what happens during the session. But at the moment, to start off with just a few bites is awesome. Just a bit of an update, and I've had a lovely little run on the bottom. I think I got about 7 or 8 decent carp, up to sort of double figures. And then I went for a little spell. I don't think they were bites, I think they were liners. I've this like 8 or 9 indications. And I thought I'd pick the pellet wag up just to have a look. We've been fishing for like an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes. Just pinging those 8 mils over the top. And I picked the pellet wag up. I was fishing about 2 foot, I went out, never had a sign. I was just about to put it back down. And I just put about another foot on, went out, nothing. And I thought, right, I've just put another foot on. And straight away I've had two. This is the second one. Oh, he's trying to get under that platform. Get out of there. And this is something you've got to be aware of. Sometimes pellet wag the fish and you've got to fish deeper than what the fish are, but catch on the drop. And that is exactly what that was. That basically hit the water, and within like a split second, the line was gone. And that's my second one on the pellet wag. And I'll get him in, just show you exactly how deep I'm fishing at the moment. But I think at the moment, it's going to be the case of just keep casting and casting. They're all absolutely stunning fish. Perfectly hooked that. Never going to come off, but I need this gorge right. So I just put that carp in the net, and I'm fishing, I reckon, three and a bit foot deep. So I started off at like 2, went down a bit more, nothing, just went down about another 10 inches, 12 inches, and I've had 2 bites, but I've not had those bites at that depth. Them bites have been where the wag has settled, and what I'll show you now is exactly what I'm doing. Let me just catapult a few pellets out before I cast out, not loads, 4 or 5. Like twice. If you do it twice, it's like on the pole sometimes, just makes a bit more noise. Get him out and then stop him and then stop. Don't wind at all. And you just want that pellet, that land past your float. And sometimes I've been to venues before and you'll get a, if you fish too, even though them carp are shallow, they won't have a real shallow, it's like they come to the sort of noise of the float, but they won't come to the float. And that pellet that drops past, even though it's like, there you go, look at that. Oh, come off that. That's because I was like trying to explain to you guys, I never had my hand on my rod. So let's just cast that again. And that was actually a bite at that depth then. So it looks to me at the moment like they're there. They've come off the bottom from obviously feeding on that bottom wag. So stop it and then concentrate. Obviously I'm not sinking the line on this. That float max is nice and floaty. Got a bit of a side wind, but it's not too bad. And then you can just wind the rod or wind the reel real quick just to bounce that pellet up. Like I said, I've only just been on it like 10 minutes. I've had two, but obviously at that depth. This is where you've got to try and feel your way into it. Is it going to be one of them days where you've got to keep casting? I would have, nowadays for me, pellet Waggler fishing is about casting all the time, especially on venues that the carp are a bit wary. So feed, just wind in as quick as you can. Might even have to go a little bit deeper. So cast, stop, on the rest. Don't want to drag that float at all towards me. It's literally in and stop. And feed a few pellets. A couple of quick winds to try and bounce that pellet up in the air or up in the water a little bit. That last fish felt, it wasn't very big, so it might have been an F1. It definitely wasn't one of the big carp. And sometimes you've got to be a little bit patient. So certain venues you go to, and you can actually sit there and let the pellet hang, and then all of a sudden, wallop, they'll have it. But whether this is going to be like that today, I don't know. I think the last time I come here, I actually done a bit of filming on here a couple of years ago, and you had to be like literally constantly in and out all the time, and the bites you got were basically on the drop or very, very fast after your float goes in. Might only get a couple, might have to go back down again. A little bit shorter that time just to try it. Sometimes it's worth casting beyond your bait. That's what I said, you've got to try and keep those pellets in the same little tiny dink then, probably a roach I would say. If there's a few F1s about, they will be an absolute nightmare to catch on a pellet Waggler, believe me. They're not the easiest fish to catch on a, especially an 8mm pellet. So stop that. Not caught anything else. Most of them have been between 5 and 10 pound, I would say, the fish that I've had. There's no F1s or anything at the moment, which the way I'm fishing doesn't surprise me, to be honest, with 8mm pellets. Even though they will suck an 8mm in. Yeah, beautiful that. Yeah, look at that. Beautiful. So I would say that was virtually just as the pellet was getting to the full depth then. So never be scared to, you know, fish a pellet wag a little bit deeper. Got me 12 foot rod now, obviously. And fishing a 12 or 11 when you're doing this sort of fishing is so much quicker than the 13. It's just simpler to use. 13 foot is a little bit clumsy sometimes. fishing a pellet wag, especially at the distance I'm fishing. That's the thing, you can really get into them with a 12 foot rod. Ooh, you see how deep that is? It's probably getting on for 4 foot now. And it's just started raining, which ain't great. We don't really want rain if we're trying to catch. Ooh, it's come off at the net. What an absolute gutter. Gutted. A big fish as well, that was. What an absolute gutter. Anyway, it does happen to me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not going to lie, I do lose a few fish, as we all do. It was tangled around his dorsal, actually, and then it sort of flicked off. So anyway, let's get back to it. A few pellets. Not quite sure yet about the feeding pattern. Remember to keep feeding twice. That's the nice thing about having that big rod rest. You don't even have to look. You can just drop your rod down. You're concentrating on your float. It's weird, nowadays I find that you've got to work really hard. Maybe not on every venue, you can just let it sit there and it goes under, but a lot of pellet fishing for me nowadays is about being in and out all the time and basically catching the fish on the drop. Unless there's a group of fish there, and you can feed over top your float and get a bite. That's not going to be the case at the moment. Maybe later on. I always treat it a bit like F1 fishing. I've done a lot of F1 fishing shallow, and you can prime a line up, and you can even have the fish boiling. And you think, right, here we go. And you go out and you catch two or three, and then they're gone, and you've got to go back on the bottom again, and you've got to treat this the same. It's not, you know, it might not be one of them days where you can just keep plodding away shallow. And you might be missing, you know, obviously still feeding. Them fish on the bottom, the ones that are on the bottom, will get confident again. And I'm only going to give this a couple more casts. But I've hooked three after two and a bit hours. So it looks like, you know, later on we might have a nice run on it. If the sun come out, it'd be even better. I do like this. I love the pellet wag, especially when the line goes. You cast out and it's like zzz. I remember I used to fish Gold Valley years ago. It was amazing. I could never get my head round, even on like a scud, what we used to call like a scud waggler, which was like a big 15, 16 gram wag. I used to chuck it out in the middle of the lakes and it used to go plop. And as the float hit the surface, your rod would be like that immediately with the fish on, and you just couldn't get your head round how quick they respond to noise. It was absolutely amazing. It was mega when you caught on it. It was a great way of fishing. Hard work, winding in and out all the time, but it was fantastic fishing. And some of the biggest fish in the lake as well. Big, big wise ones that are just cruising around. This was in the winter time as well. Give us a couple more casts. I did actually chuck that off the bank, the back of my feed that time, but nothing. That sun's just starting to break through now. Hopefully, that will be like a trigger, I think, if it comes out and it... Obviously steamed under that. That was it, that full depth, that was. Just sat there. It keeps you going. You know they sort of want to come up. As they were settled on the bottom, not many indications, but every indication was virtually a fish. And then all of a sudden it was like indication, nothing. You think, right. It's lovely when the wind is like directly off your back, because everything stays, especially when you're on the pellet waggler, it keeps everything. The wind keeps your line tight to your float. And sometimes you don't even have to strike. They'll literally just take the rod round. I don't normally give them time to do that. I'm normally on the bite immediately. Oh, one's just top there then. Just sense I've had them few bites. I know I missed a bite a minute ago, but you just sense that I've spooked them off a bit by hooking a couple. Let's go back on the deck for a bit. Nice fishing though. Had a few bites, which is encouraging. Straight back on the bottom. And up one straight away. Actually, it's one of the smaller ones I've had today, to be fair. Looks like one of the... they've put a few small ones in. Look at him. Absolutely stunning common. God, yeah. Probably like looks about 2 pound, he's probably about 4. It's absolutely stunning. All the hooks come out in the net. Look at him. Willowmarsh, beautiful. So I've just gone back on the deck. And I think it is going to be one of them days where you might get a few indications. That was literally straight in, straight down. 20 seconds. And straight in. And I think it's going to be one of them days where you might nick a few on the pellet wag. I will have another go, obviously. But I'm just going to carry on with this. It's such good fishing as well. It's so enjoyable doing something slightly different. And I think you miss out on... Obviously, the conditions have got to be right. But honestly, if you get it right, especially even if you're a match angler like me, mid-match, if you come to a fishery like I am today, where you've got a bit of open water... You can actually like just feed it and go on it. And if they're on those 8 mils on the wag, it can make a huge difference to your match fishing. I know we all go bomb fishing that now, but I'm sure we miss bites, but we get the fish, pick the bait up, spit it back out. But with this wag, you definitely get less of it. And I'm just gonna carry on fishing this bottom for a little bit more. And I reckon what'll happen is I'll keep feeding and I'll start getting indications again. And I might be able to come shallow late in the session and have a little run on that pellet wag. But it is starting to rain again now, just starting to spit, so that might not help it at all, especially for fishing shallow. Hopefully it won't get up to, just want that sun to break through. If that sun broke through, I know they'd be straight up. There's obviously a few of them there already. I've hooked three on that pellet wag in that sort of half hour, 40 minute spell. But this is just nice. It's just nice fishing. I'm missing an odd indication. Then I went through that, you know, a good spell of catching fish. And then all of a sudden there was like lots of, not loads of indications, but enough indications to think I have to try up in the water with that pellet wag. Oh, I absolutely nailed that. You can probably hear the clutch go on that. That's because I'm striking hard and that's how I've got that clutch set. So if I did hook one, I'm not going to break my hook length. Nice. So I'm going to carry on with this and I'll get back to you and hopefully we'll have a few more on that pellet wag as we come to the end. Another on the bottom, on that bottom wag, on that 13 footer. a little spell where I've had a few indications. I tried the pellet wag again, I only missed a bite. I've varied it from different depths, but nothing. You can just sense that this sun just won't break through. And I'm sure if it did, we have hooked three on a pellet wag. But you can just tell, I've probably put a little bit too much bait in trying to catch on that pellet wag. Where I think if I'd have fed sort of four or five pellets, I wouldn't have had any sort of, already any liners at all. Even though we've had a mega day. I mean, we've absolutely caught an absolute boatload of carp here at Willowmarsh. But that, fishing that wag on the bottom has been the way forward. And like I said at the start of the film, it is a great way, you know, very underestimated on a lot of waters I go to. And it's something that I carry in the van. Definitely don't do it as much as what I should do. I think we all get sort of in, you know, we get set in our ways sometimes. And this style of fishing, believe you me, can be absolutely deadly. I have had an absolute, it looks like it's going to absolutely pour down. You can see it's sort of just specking me brain now. And I'm going to call this the last fish because I think me and Jamie's going to get electrocuted on the camera. And I don't really want to get soaking wet, but we've had a mega day. Probably caught 20 odd carp up to 10 pound, which is absolutely mega. This is another beautiful fish. Does that take it out of your gear, oh? These size fish. So definitely go out and hope, you know, take the sort of tips that I've given you today. Simple setup, just that Waggler kit with the stops, the rubber stops on it. That's such a good thing about today. You don't have to have them great big shot on your line. It's going to damage your shot. Two number eight stops down just to give that line, you know, just to keep it a little bit tighter. 5-6 pound. Oh, Christ. That is not happy. 5 or 6 pound main line. 5 pounds bang on today for what I'm doing, fishing that distance. Every single carp we've caught have absolutely proper give it a good scrap. That 015's been bang on for it today. Didn't have to fish any heavier. I just love fishing balanced tackle. Not overgunning it. Look at that. Absolute beautiful. That's probably close to £9, I would say. Oh, maybe 10. That's a good fish, that. I said, back on the bottom. Not had a single tangle. It's just starting to rain a bit heavier now. I'm going to hold this one up to show you guys exactly what Willowmarsh is all about. If you fancy a bit of waggler fishing, definitely one of them venues you can come. I bet you've picked up some nice little tips on how to catch these beautiful fish on the waggler. Don't forget to subscribe and like the Preston YouTube channel. It's not very happy about being caught on the waggler, to be honest. And yeah, thanks for watching and see you on the next time.